Good evening, and I welcome you students. It's going to be a live webinar. It's going to be a live session. There will be question answer sessions and important MCQ questions and other type of questions will be discussed in this. You will be participating and answering the question. Before we begin the session, you sit comfortably for a few warm-up exercises. Activate our body, improve the energy levels, relieve the stress, sit comfortably. We are beginning with first one, Bastrika. Inhale up, exhale down. Ready? Ready?
Yes.
Okay, start. 10 rounds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now neck, no stress should be there. We must release the stress or stiffness from the neck. So we will do right, inhale, exhale, left. 5 times. 3, 4, 5. Okay, neck down, up. Inhale, exhale. Come back. Give a clockwise rotation 3 times, half inhale, half exhale. Be gentle and slow. Anti-clockwise 3 times, slow and gentle with your neck. Come back. Shoulders rotation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Reverse 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, come back. Inhale, finger open, exhale, closed. 5 times. Okay, come back. Tap your feet on the ground. Tap your feet on the ground 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10. Okay, activated the body. Energy levels improved. Stiffness released from the body. Now we'll do some deep breathing. Deep breathing techniques are very good. When you inhale deeply, exhale, then focus becomes better. We can do better focus and distractions become out and mind comes in the relaxed state. That's very important when we do any question answer session, any reading, any studies. So we will do some deep breathing. What will we do? We will inhale from the nostril with the closed eyes deeply, and we will make a honeybee sound when we will do the exhaling with closed mouth. Sit comfortably, relax yourself. Now your feet are touching the ground. Close your eyes. Observe your breath for a few moments. Observe your breath. Inhale, exhale, observe your breath. Experience the breathing. When you inhale, your chest and belly expands, and when you exhale, your belly and chest contracts. Now we start our breathing. Be breathing. We'll make the sound of beep. Inhale deeply. Exhale by zoo. Breathing sound. Start. Mm-hmm. second round. Inhale deeply. Third round, inhale as deeply as possible, release it by the zoo honeybee sound. Third, fourth round. Last round. Come back to the original state. Keep breathing, normal breathing, gentle breathing, soft breathing. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Fold your hands, rub your two hands, experience the heat, heating of the two hands, like a magnetic field, put this field on your two eyes and on the face for a few moments. Keep inhaling and exhaling. Relax, become aware of your surroundings, experience the vibrations inside your body, the sensations inside your body. Now you fold your hands for the prayer to the God and the universe, to the environment because of which we live. We thank you, God, we thank you, universe, we thank you, environment, for we breathe and exist, and we promise to do our best and concentrate and focus on our work. Now you can open your eyes with smiles. Three claps. One, two, three. Okay, come back. All right, students, you are back. Tell me, do you get some energy? Are you getting some energy or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Are you relaxed or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we will begin the session. Keep your notebooks, pen, everything ready, and we are going to start.
Okay, students, this is a live webinar. Students, we are going to work on question answer sessions. And let me tell you, student, we have done the topic of student force and laws of motion. Did we do that with you? Participate in the live webinar, force and laws of motion. Okay. Ninth class, which chapter is this, student? Chapter 9, and I am your science and life coach. Science and life coach. And students can talk with me on my mobile number also, and my WhatsApp and YouTube channel is already there for students to see the recorded videos and learn free of cost all chapters of science for all classes. No problem. Students' participation is absolutely essential, because then we will learn more students, and the coaches get motivated when students work hard. And thereby coaches are also students. they are also learning from the students. Okay, here are the questions on the screen. Before we have a small summary of what we have learned, student, we studied the first law of motion. Object continues to be in a state of rest or of uniform motion along a straight line unless acted upon by unbalanced force. The natural tendency of objects is what we call as inertia, and inertia depends on the mass. The larger the mass, the greater is the property of inertia in bodies. Force of friction always opposes the motion of the objects. It's important when moving object comes to rest because of the force of friction. If there was no friction, we won't be able to walk, you are aware of. The second law of motion stated rate of change of momentum. Rate of change of momentum of an object is proportional to applied unbalanced force. The momentum of an object was studied because it shows the impact of an object on a particular when one body collides with other depends on mass and product velocity. The third law of motion explained when force acts on one body, another body exerts equal and opposite force. What they talked of action and reactions. How the satellites move up, the gases are out. So how you walk on the ground, students, action and reaction is working on two different bodies always. And then we studied the law of conservation of momentum. In an isolated system, when there is no external force, the total momentum is conserved. Bodies may collide before collision and after collision, the total momentum will remain the same. These are some of the things we have learned in this chapter on the basis of which questions are coming. First question is on the screen. Which of the following statement is not correct? Please read the questions very carefully, student. Not correct. Question can be correct or not correct. We should be sure what we are talking about, student. In this, he is talking not correct. For an object moving along a straight path in an accelerated motion, the choices are its speed keeps changing, its velocity always changes, it always go away from the earth, force is always acting on it. What is the correct answer, students?
Sir, option C.
If an object is moving along a straight path in an accelerated motion, what do you mean by accelerated motion, students? What happens if something is accelerated? Its speed keeps on changing. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Correct. Please read everything carefully. Questions could be changed by just instead of not correct, I can make correct. So depends. We must understand everything very clearly. Pay attention, focus, concentrate. We have a target. We set up, okay, we will solve question answer sessions. Then we have an intention. We will focus and concentrate and answer the questions. Its velocity always changes. Is this statement correct?
Yes, sir.
Correct statement. There is nothing to hurry up, student. Let us understand very slowly. It always go away from the earth. Is it the correct statement?
No, sir.
Not correct. A force is always acting on it. When body is being accelerated, sir. What it means? This is a correct statement. All right, then what answer we have, students? The only answer which we left is C is the correct answer, and you are given one full mark for that, students. Next question is on the screen, student. According to third law of motion, action and reaction, we have just discussed it. Always act on the same body, always act on different bodies in opposite directions, have same magnitude and direction, act on either body at normal to each other. What is the correct answer, students?
ऑप्शन बी।
ऑप्शन बी यू आर सेइंग लेट अस गो थ्रू ईच ऑप्शन स्लोली एंड सी, ऑलवेज एक्ट ऑन द सेम बॉडी, इज द स्टेटमेंट करेक्ट?
नो सर।
नॉट करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, वेरी गुड, ओके। ऑलवेज एक्ट ऑन डिफरेंट बॉडीज इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन, दिस इज ए करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, ओके। हैव द सेम मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन, मैग्नीट्यूड इज सेम बट डायरेक्शन इज अपोजिट, सो नॉट करेक्ट, नॉट करेक्ट। ऑल राइट, हाउ डू वी इलिमिनेट द चॉइसेस? एक्ट ऑन आइदर बॉडी एट नॉर्मल टू ईच अदर, दे आर एक्टिंग इक्वल एंड अपोजिट टू ईच अदर, नॉट करेक्ट। So the answer then is B. B is the correct answer, student. What happened? B is the correct answer, students. B is the correct answer. B is the correct answer, students. Okay. We have to study and read all the choices very carefully before we answer the question. That is my objective, students. That do not answer any question in a hurry without reading every statement clearly. Read every part carefully, pay attention, focus, concentrate, then answer the question. You will get sufficient time in the exam to answer the question. Next question is coming on the screen, student. A goalkeeper in a game of football pulls his hands backward after holding the ball short at the goal. This enables the goalkeeper to exert larger force, reduce the force exerted by the ball on end, increase the rate of change of momentum, decrease the rate of change of momentum, student. What are the correct answers here, student? Your time is running out, students.
Sir, option D.
Reduce the force exerted by the ball. Why the force is reduced, student?
Sir, since momentum is reduced as time is increasing.
So then decrease the rate of change of momentum also. Right?
Yes,
what will happen? Then what will happen? Then he won't be hurt. Otherwise, what will happen? If the time is short, then the rate of change of momentum is large. And what will happen? Then he will be hurt. Therefore, this is the correct answer. Read everything carefully before answering the question. Question 4 is on the screen, students. The inertia of an object tends to cause the object to increase its speed, to decrease its speed, to resist any change in its state of motion, to accelerate due to friction. We have studied what is inertia, students. What is the correct answer?
Sir, option C.
Option C. First, to increase speed, wrong. To decrease speed, wrong. Correct. To accelerate due to friction, wrong. So C is the correct answer. That is absolutely right, students. We can proceed further. Next question is on the screen, student. A passenger in a moving train tosses a coin which falls behind him. It means the motion of the train. It means the motion of the train, student. accelerated uniform retarded along circular track. What it means, students, read every statement carefully before answering the questions.
Option A.
That means what is happening, student? When the train is moving accelerated, means its velocity is increasing, what happens? Then you toss a coin, it will fall in front or back? Why it falls on the back, student? What is the reason for that?
So because of inertia of motion.
Because of inertia. What law is there also? Action and reaction. Okay, this is what we will see. Inertia. Inertia is there. You are at rest, the train is moving. What will happen? Okay, next question is coming on the screen, student. An object of mass 2 kg is sliding with constant velocity of 4 meter per second on frictional less horizontal table. The force required to keep the object moving with the same velocity is. What is the force, students?
Sir, option B, 0 newtons.
0 newtons? Yes, why, sir. No force is required here? Because the velocity is not changing. Because the velocity is constant. And it is moving with the same velocity, then force will be equal to 0 newtons. All right, that is the correct answer. No force is required. The body will continue to move with constant velocity. Question number 7 is on the screen, student. Rocket runs on the principle of conservation of. What is the principle of conservation when the rocket? What happens to the rocket, students? You have seen the blast of the rockets, how they are launched, launching of the rockets. You have seen in the pictures how the rocket goes up, the gases coming out, a lot of fire and all that, and blast. So what is the principle of conservation which is applied?
Sir, momentum.
Yes, it moves with, it has a mass and velocity. So what happens, it was at rest before and after that it moves, and there is the exit of the gases. You have seen the total momentum will be conserved is the correct answer. Next question, students. A water tanker filled up to of its height is moving with uniform speed. On sudden application of breakwater in the tank would move backward, move forward to be unaffected, rise upwards. Rise upwards.
Sir, move forward.
Move forward.
Yes.
But is the reason for that, students?
Sir, inertia of motion.
What happens? Water tank is filled up to height, moving with uniform. On sudden, now everything is moving and you apply a brake. You still want to be in the same state. When you stop, then what happens? The water would move forward. Move forward. Okay, it's a correct answer. There are three solids made up of aluminium, steel, and wood of the same shape, same volume. Which of them has the highest inertia? How would you decide, student?
Sir, the mass of, we will see the mass of each of them. And those mass which will be greater, that will have greater inertia.
What he says, volume is same. Sorry, mass is equal to density into volume. This is same. So the density, the one which will be most dense, which has the highest density, that will have the largest mass. More density means more mass and more inertia. Which one has the highest density out of the three? Density, which is more dense, student? Density. So we have to understand what is the density here. You can sip water. Sip water. I'm not saying drink water. I'm saying sipping water. Water has a healing energy. Healing energy. I say water, heal me. And sip a water. Sip the water. So what is the answer coming then?
Sir, aluminium.
The density of aluminium is highest. Highest density of aluminium. Then we are saying aluminium because same volume is there, same shape is there, then the density is of the aluminium is more. Therefore, you are saying that it has higher inertia of the three solids. Next question. Two balls of the same size but of different materials, rubber and iron, are set on smooth floor of a moving train. The brakes are applied suddenly to stop the. Will the balls start rolling? If so, in which direction? Will they move in the same speed? Give reasons for your answer. What is the answer you are giving, students?
Sir, both balls will start rolling.
Both will roll. Where they will roll? Forward or backward?
Sir, forward.
Rolls. Which will, if which direction? Will they move with the same speed or different speeds?
Sir, different speed.
different speeds. Which one will move faster?
Rubber ball.
On what basis you are saying?
Sir, since iron ball has greater mass, then it will have less acceleration.
Iron ball has more mass. Rubber ball has less mass. Force is equal to m into a. Force is same, then acceleration is inversely proportional to the mass. Acceleration inversely proportional to the mass. That's what we are saying. Therefore, rubber ball will move faster.
Yes, sir.
Rubber ball will have more speed. Okay. We have to understand and then only we can answer the question, students. Two identical bullets are fired, one with light rifle, another with heavy rifle with the same force. Which rifle will hurt the shoulder more and why? Everything, think before you answer the question. Students, think before you answer the question.
Sir, light rifle will hurt the shoulder more.
What happens in this case? What is the law which we are applying, student? Which law we are using?
The third law.
Law of conservation of momentum.
Yes, sir.
Before you fire the bullet, both are at rest. You have a light rifle and heavy rifle. And forces are equal. F equal. But acceleration is inversely proportional to mass. So action and reaction is taking place. The bullet moves forward. And the gun recoils. So the one which has a lighter mass. Theek hai? Will force is same, but what will happen? Acceleration will be more. Will recoil. Yes, sir. Will recoil more. Because acceleration is inversely proportional to the mass. Therefore, which will hurt the shoulder more? Lighter rifle. That is the reason you've seen rifles are made very heavy. So heavy that the recoiling is very small. And you have seen big. Wo jo top hoti hai, uska bhi tumne dekha kya, kitna heavy hota wo. You have seen tanks and all that, which fire, release yes, bombs with very high velocity. How much is the weight of that? How much is the weight of those? How many tons of is the weight of the tank and all those which fire these at a very high speed? So they are working on the scientific principles which we have studied. And that is why we accepted these laws of the motion, because they are not being violated by whatever we do whatever experiments, activities, or whatever we are doing in everyday life, students. Next question is coming, students. A horse continues to apply a force in order to move a cart with constant speed. Explain why. Explain why, student.
Sir, this is because of third law of motion.
Third law of motion, how will you explain? Horse applies a force. What happened? Horse pushes the ground.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And the ground applies an equal and opposite force on the horse, due to which, what happens?
The horse.
Cart will also move with constant speed. With constant speed. Okay. Suppose a ball of mass M is thrown vertically upward with initial speed of u. Its speed decreases continuously till it becomes zero. Then what happens? Thereafter, the ball begins to fall downward and attain speed u again before striking the ground. It implies magnitude of initial and final momentum ball are the same. Yes, it is not an, yet it is not example of conservation of momentum. Explain. What is happening here, student? This is a ball. You are throwing it upward. After reaching a height, what happens? It will become zero when it comes to rest. After that, the ball starts falling down and attains speed u again before striking the ground. And finally, it falls on the ground. It implies that the magnitude of initial and final momentum are same. Initial and final, yet it is not an example of conservation of momentum. What is the reason?
Because of the inconservation of momentum, there are action and reaction forces.
There is a gravitational force of the earth. Due to which it is moving with and falling towards the earth with constant acceleration. We know about it, acceleration due to gravity. But there is acceleration due to gravity. In this case, the earth has a gravitational force, student, with which it pulls the objects towards itself. Okay. Next question. Velocity versus time graph of mass 50 gram rolling on concrete floor is shown. Calculate acceleration and frictional force. Frictional force. On the ball. You have 2 minutes to answer the question, students. What is the mass student?
50 gram.
Which will mean 50 Five. By 1000.
Yes, sir.
0.05 kg. This is the figure. What is this? 80?
Yes, sir.
Velocity in meter per second. What is the initial velocity? Initial velocity of the ball, student? How much?
80 meter per second.
What is the final velocity?
0 meter per second.
Okay. Then what is the time? T, how much time it takes?
8 seconds.
0 to 8, this is the point, 8 seconds. Then what is the acceleration? Students, how much is it?
Minus 10 meter per second square.
You know why it is minus? Because it is acting in a direction opposite to it. Then what do we have to calculate, student? What is the force? What is the mass value?
0.05.
Acceleration?
0.5.
How much we get?
Minus 5 kg meter per second square.
Minus 5?
Minus 0.5.
Minus 0.5. Which means minus 0.5 Newton, student. This is the force. Then what is the frictional force? What is the frictional force, student, then? This is the frictional force is minus 0.5 Newton, student, because it acts in a direction opposite to the direction of the motion of the ball. That is why it stops. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. A truck of mass M is moved under a force F. If the truck is then loaded with an object equal to mass of the truck and driving force is half, then how does the acceleration change, student? F is equal to, student, mass into acceleration. If M is the mass of the truck, F is acting, if the truck is then loaded with an object equal to mass of the truck, then what happens to the F? F dash, what is the mass now?
2m.
2m. M plus m. 2m. And the driving force is halved. What is F dash? 1 by 2f. Then yes, how does the acceleration change? What is the acceleration here? F by m a1. And what is the acceleration here? F dash is equal to 2m into a2. 1 by 2f is equal to 2m into a2. What is a2? 1 by 4 f by m. So how much it has reduced? A2 is equal to 1 by 4 of A1. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So how much it reduces? Acceleration reduced 1 by 4th. Next question. Two friends on roller skates are standing 5 meters apart, facing each other. One of them throws a ball of 2 kg towards the other. Who catches it? How will this activity affect the position of the two? Explain. Explain it, students.
Sir, they will move apart.
Move apart? How do we say? Then what we say? Apart is not the right word which we use. They are standing. You throw a ball. What happens? What happens? Both will move forward or backward? First will move forward or backward?
Sir, backward.
So, and second one? What will happen to the two friends?
Sir, they will move backward.
Both? Both move backward. Backward. Which law is being applied?
Sir, second law.
Water sprinter used for grass lawns begins to rotate as soon as water is supplied. Explain the principle on which it works. You have seen in the gardens when water is coming out, what is happening to that sprinkler, the one which sprinkles the water? Does it start rotating?
Yes, sir.
Why?
Sir, this is because when water is supplied, it has high velocity, which increases the momentum. So,
then what will happen?
Due to the force exerted, it will move.
See that whenever questions are given, students, you have to understand the question, and you may be knowing it, but if answer is not appropriate, no marks will be allowed in the exam. You have to be sure what answer we are giving. What you write will be the one which will be evaluated. It is not that what you know. Questions should be read very clearly before we answer the He is saying explain the principle on which it works. So you have to name the principle, nothing else. student, your time is running out. How many laws you have studied?
Three laws.
Which law is this?
That's second law.
It is not second law. What is? How is it? Water is coming out, and what will happen? Equal and opposite force will be exerted. Water comes out, equal and opposite force is exerted when it starts rotating. There is action and reaction. The rockets are going up, other gases are coming out. You have seen that also. So what law is applicable here, student? All right, student, these are the NCERT exemplar questions which were given by NCERT, important question for the students. We have explained them, we have solved them, and you can, the most important purpose is, students, that we should study more and more. The more you study, the more you learn. The whole game is to focus, concentrate, take your time and learn. When we study chapters, we must know how to solve the questions. We have solved the NCERT exercise in the previous lectures. We are doing some important questions, MCQ and other type of important questions which can be asked to you. This whole game is to give you practice so that in different exams, you can think and answer the questions. No question be answered in a hurry. There will be time will be available for us. Take your time, work out the answer, then you answer. Understanding of the question is very important. If we don't understand the question, we cannot give an answer. So try to understand the question and learn different topics very clearly, thoroughly. And therefore, we will continue more in the next topic, in the next lectures. Then I will see you in the next class. This part is over. Okay. Bye-bye. Then I see you in the next class.
Thank you, sir.